And I was like, I want to go back and eat the leeks and the fish we had in Egypt. Maybe hard, at least I ate much I wanted to eat. So what did God do? He started testing them. What was in their heart? He started murmuring, complaining. Immediately, murmuring, complaining. He delivered them from their hard taskmasters. The Egyptians didn't play with the Jews. They treated them terrible. They didn't play with them. But when you're in a hard situation, it crushes your spirit. And you have what's called a slave mentality, or mentality accepts the situation without even challenging it. He said, I'm going to test what's in your heart, because I can take I can take you out of Egypt, but I can take Egypt out of you. See what I'm saying? Now, I can take you out of prison, but God can take the prison out of you. God can take you out of drugs, God can take the desire of drugs out of you. Remember, when you come out of physically, God can take it out spiritually out of your heart. Goes on to say, he humbled you by letting you go hungry, and he gave you manna to eat, which your fathers and your fathers had not known, so that you may know that man does not live by bread alone, but every word that proceeds out of the mouth of God. Your clothes did not wear out, and your feet did not swell before you shot right there. God tested He says, I allowed you to go hungry, and I gave you the same food over and over again. Manna, in the morning, 7 days, 6 days a week, on 6 days, they had double. Same food. They had the same clothes. Their clothes didn't wear out, and their shoes didn't wear out. For 40 years, think about that. For 40 years, their shoes didn't wear out, and their clothes didn't wear out.
Praise God.
And God gave the same food over and over and over and over. Why do you do that? Why does God allow us to go through trials? I'm talking God ordained trials. Why does God allow us to go through that when he's God of the universe, he gives me anything he wants? What did he say? So that you may live by every word that proceeds out of my mouth. What is God trying to teach the Egyptians, teach the Israelites who came out of Egypt? If you're a slave and you're just being beat down, you just didn't survive the world. Well, I live by eating through my stomach. Whatever I can eat, that's the only pleasure I'm getting, because I'm in such a hard situation that they beat me down. I am a beast of burden for the time I get up, the time I get down. Only time I get the rest is when I sleep and I eat. So getting out of survival mode into realizing you don't live by your stomach. You live by principle. You live by principle. I will teach you to live by my statutes. What I say to you, what I tell you is who you are, not what people say who you are. I will tell you who you are. I'm going to speak to your heart and say, you're going to live at a higher standard. If you do not take where you're at and live by a higher standard, you'll stay down here all the time. Mm-hmm. God is saying, man does not live by the bread alone, but by every word that is seated out of my mouth. You shall wake up in the morning and work as you eat all the time. God is saying, this food is nice, but it's not your destiny. It is not where you're going in life. This is just part of the package. This is not the objective. It's a means to an end, not the objective. But what happens here is when things are bad in your life, what they went through was horrible for 30 years. Only pleasure they had was eating. Only time they had peace was when they slept. And the other time it was constant the whip. Constant the beat down, constantly disrespected by the Egyptians, calling them all kind of names. And so they were treated like dogs for years, treated like dogs. So when you treat some, dehumanize someone, they're in a survival mode, all they worry about is eating me. So God is challenging and says, I'm going to put you through a test. Well, I'm going to show you miracles, signs, and wonders. And I'm going to try to do a shift in your heart. Stop focusing on the natural, just survival, and focus on the Word of God.